Doug Roark. Dr. Roark is the Assistant Superintendent and Innovation Leader for the Falcon Zone. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Roark.
Thank you, Cheryl. From the Falcon Zone family, I say congratulations to the Falcon High School class of 2016. We have some very special guests who are here to honor you, our esteemed graduates, your families, and friends. Our Falcon High School administrators, Cheryl DeGeorge, principal, Drew Cleveland, assistant principal, and Randy Henson, assistant principal. We also have Erica Mason, our Falcon Zone instruction and assessment administrator, Melinda Keck, the principal of Falcon Elementary, Dr. Kathy Pickering, the principal of Woodman Hills Elementary, Kim Leone, the principal of Meridian Ranch Elementary School, and Brian Smith, the principal of Falcon Middle School. We also have guests from our District 49 staff. Peter Hiltz, our Chief Education Officer, Jack Bay, our Chief Operations Officer, Brett Ridgway, our Chief Business Officer, Zach Craddock, our Director of Individualized Education, Dr. Lou Fletcher, our Coordinator, Director of Cultural Capacity, Amber Wedstein, our Executive Director of Learning Services, and guests from the District 49 Board of Education. Tammy Harold, Kevin Butcher, and John Graham. We also have former board member Chuck Irons, who is also the father of Lauren, who is graduating today. And Cheryl, I'll turn it back over to you.
Next, we actually have a musical number. Valedictorian and salutatorian. With a cumulative GPA of 4.3, our valedictorian is Ms. Riley Jones, the daughter of Carolyn and Randy Jones. Following graduation, Riley plans to attend Cornell University, where she will study biological sciences in preparation for attending veterinary school. We will hear Ms. Jones' speech later in this ceremony. Next, our salutatorian, Mr. Anthony Wentz, has a GPA of 4.26, and he is the son of Lillian Barron and Matthew Wentz. Anthony will be attending.
Class of 2016. It has been four long, seemingly never-ending years since we have started high school. There are so many great memories from the past 12 years. Elementary school? Yeah, that time was the best. If only we're a high school class, though. Middle school, our awkward phases, and then came high school. The four longest years we've ever experienced. But let's be honest, the most important question over the past 4 years has been, is this formative or summative? And for those of you that don't know, that essentially means, do I need to do this assignment or not? Knowing Mr. Kennedy, the answer to this question, among all other questions, would be, it depends. On behalf of the class 2016, I would like to thank all teachers, admin, and staff at Falcon High School for making our time here as painless as possible. Also, we would like to thank our parents for all their help over the past 18 years or so. The last shout out goes to Lincharts, Google Translate, and Wikipedia. There's a long list of accomplishments for the class of 2016. For starters, we were the class that banned the use of rubber dodgeballs at Falcon High School. In all reality, though, we've always been a class that gets the job done, regardless of situations we were put in. Many teachers have said that the class of 2016 has had the worst attendance record, or that we look for loopholes in the system. These are both true. But as I said before, we get the job done, and there's almost 300 of us graduating today, and that's pretty impressive. The class 2016 has a bright future when it comes to the armed forces. We have 6 military academy appointments, numerous students enlisted in the United States military, with many more planning to do the same. It is great that we have so many men and women that care about our country to the point that they would lay down their lives to uphold the Constitution and all this country stands for. On behalf of the class of 2016, I would like to thank all current and former military, as well as their families. Many students in our class have developed a deep hatred for AP Chemistry students. We all remember sophomore year on the close day of the year when the AP Chem students decided it would be a great idea to set a gummy bear on fire. This caused us all to go outside for about a half hour or so. Yeah, just as if this wasn't crazy enough, those same students decided to send a hazmat team to our school the following week. Yeah, good times. I think the class of 2016 has set a record for the most snow days over the course of 4 years at Falcon High School. Our senior class has to be one of the most devoted classes ever to graduate from high school. All that devotion, though, has been put towards finding ways to skip school. And I think we've devised more ways to skip school than I ever thought possible. Senior switch, senior skip, senior takeover, e-witches, flat-out skipping, and the list goes on. Senioritis is real. Your parents may tell you that they had to walk to school through the snow, going uphill, both ways. They can brag all they want though, because only our class had a kid get frostbite riding his bike to school. You know what though? That kid's a hero because he got us 2 hour delay the next day. The class 2016 has lived to see so many things. We have lived in 2 different millenniums. We have survived the 2008 recession when people thought the world was going to end. We have lived to see the existence and sudden death of the whip, the dab, and the possum. And we have survived both the swine flu and Ebola. Those are real accomplishments right there. In all reality though, our class has had to overcome numerous obstacles, like 7 grading systems. and in the end, each one of us here today has made it. We have left a lasting legacy on Falcon High School, and I think that we've made underclassmen's lives much more difficult. Due to our class's severe case of senioritis, now underclassmen have to apply to be part of AP classes. Mr. Kennedy loves to talk about scarcity, and let me tell you, one thing that was definitely scarce in the class 2016? Motivation. You know what though? Every class has its disappointments, and in my opinion, our greatest disappointment was the failure to crack the school Wi-Fi code our entire senior year. We had the password our first 3 years, but looking back, it's pretty devastating to realize we went an entire year without the school Wi-Fi password. A wise man, future president, and philosopher once told me, you guys may know it, have fun, be safe, make smart decisions, have a great weekend. We would always laugh when Mr. Kennedy would tell us this, but in all honesty, when you think about what he's saying, it couldn't be more true. When we all leave here today, have fun in life. Do what makes you happy and become successful. Live a safe life. Don't go making stupid decisions that you're going to end up regretting. Make smart decisions. Invest money. Remember, Kennedy says that compound interest is a great thing. Surround yourselves with people that help you reach your goals, but most importantly, have a great time in your life, follow your heart, and find true happiness. God has given us all the opportunity to succeed in life, and this is the first major step for many of us. Fellow students, it's over. Congratulations to Falcon High School's Class 2016. We've made it. my marching orders to offer encouraging words. So here are the encouraging words. In 30 minutes or so, you're going to be graduates from high school. And even though you see other degrees represented up here and other educational experiences, this is the one that will shape you, because it's the one that you're going to have in common with the most people you ever meet. So it's not a small thing. Some of you may have taken it for granted, but I want to encourage you to pause through the day, connect with the people that are here, family, grandparents, friends, and acknowledge what you've done. It's not a small thing. It's actually a very big thing. I also want to respond to some things that Anthony shared with you a little bit earlier. You are the class that set the record for the most snow days before. And all I can say about those 4 years is, you're welcome. I will tell you, the first year, I'm a guy from Alaska, born and raised in Alaska. And so you know, Alaskan superintendents never call snow days. Everybody knows that. But it's not the snow days you call that matter. It's the ones you don't. And in my first year in this position, first opportunity to make that mistake, I made it. I know the date, I know what happened, and I was wrong. And you are going to make mistakes in all kinds of settings. Some of you won't get out of this building without making some sort of mistake. It's true. You might trip, you might say something to offend a friend, you might forget to get a picture with your grandparents, you're going to do something wrong. And so the encouragement that I would offer to you, which I have learned from time after time, is when you make a mistake, not if, do the next right thing. It's so easy to make a mistake behind a mistake behind a mistake. So easy. You run into somebody in the parking lot, you dent their car, what's the next right thing? Find them, own up to them, leave them a note, take care of it. The wrong thing is to drive away, and then you get all kinds of problems. You're going to take a photo that you should not take. Don't post it. That would be the mistake after the mistake. Do the next right thing and delete that photo. You're going to make a comment that's going to hurt someone. Apologize. And the great thing about doing the next right thing is that you don't have to wait until you make a mistake. You can actually do the right thing first. And if you will do the right thing in a row, you will build the legacy that you guys are leaving at Falcon High School. Make the right call, do the next right thing, and that will be what you are remembered for. That is how we want to remember you, the class of 2016. Be encouraged, feel congratulated, you've made it.
Thank you. Hey Mom. So, high school? It's over? For realsie? This isn't just another dream that I'm gonna wake up from screaming, because it's 11:35 and I haven't submitted an essay for AP Lit. Did that happen? Or the one I had with where everyone in the audience started twerking. That was pretty awkward. Hashtag awkward. But this year was pretty fun. Not like the finals and stuff, but probably lots of things. The teachers were pretty cool, I guess. Thanks for getting me A's. I really enjoyed singing. Glad you love me and selling me home.
Cross the stage today
and received their diplomas have met the requirements for graduation, as set forth by the State of Colorado and School District 49. Thank you. We'll begin with the diplomas.
Audience.
like to signify your completion of your high school graduation requirements. You may now move your tassel from the right side to the left.